This is the screen that appears when you open FL Studio by default. The most basic way to create a beat is to select some notes in the kit that's in the channel. But now we're going to add an FPC kit. Demonstrate that where you press on the pad triggers different samples. So the lower you click, the louder sample you get. Now I'm going to load a pattern from the many patterns that are available. Now I'll select some of the different kits that are available, starting with the Tama. And followed by the 808 and the 909. Lots of songs from the 80s done with both of those kits. Now I'm going to route the bass drum to mixer track 2 and the snare drum to mixer track 3. Adding the view to the mixer. And there we have track 2 and 3 set up. Now I'm going to add an effect on track 3. This has a lot of presets, including presets from expensive classic reverb units. Now I'll add a second FPC and set it to the Tama preset. I randomly pick a loop, and by good luck, it had a similar groove to the prior FPC. This time I'll route the entire kit to mixer track 4. And we'll add a flanger effect to mixer track 4. Now I'll add a guitar to the channel rack. I'll close a few windows, then I'll open the piano roll for the guitar and randomly add some notes. I'll assign the guitar to mixer track 5, and then I will add a hardcore effects. And this is why you might want to record your guitar dry and then add the effects during the mix. Just scrolling through a few of the presets, and then I'll bring up a few of the presets that I had created and saved. Now I'll bring up some of the drum fills in the kit loops. Disabling the reverb effect on the snare. The remainder of the video is just a few more loops. I've gone through in the past and identified some of my favorites. There's a lot. You can spend a lot of time finding the ones you like.